The next method of separation that we are going to do is filtration. What is filtration? The process of removing insoluble solid from a liquid by using filter paper, muslin cloth, etc. That means we use this method for separation of insoluble solid particle from a liquid. In this, the size of solid particle are very small. Suppose we take a muddy water and we allow this muddy water to pass through a filter. Now what is filter? A filter is a medium with very fine pores. Then the insoluble particle remains on the filter. The insoluble particles remain on the filter are known as residue. And the clear water that is collected is known as filtrate. You know, commonly used filter are filter paper, muslin cloth, or you can use a layer of cotton or river bed sand are also used as a filter. In filtration, the size of pores of filter is very much important. The size of the pore in filter should be smaller than the size of the particle to be removed. Like this, we can do the filtration. Here, the residue is at the top of the filter paper and we get filtrate in a beaker. Now, next method that we are going to do is evaporation and condensation. You have studied this method in your previous class also. Now, what is evaporation? You know it very well. Conversion of liquid into its vapor is known as evaporation. We can see this process in our nature also. When the temperature increases, the process of evaporation becomes faster. Due to it, the clouds are formed. You know it very well about the evaporation. Now, next method we are going to do is condensation. Now, what is condensation? It is reverse of evaporation, that is conversion of vapors of substance into a liquid state. We can see this process when we take a glass containing chilled water. You have seen the tiny droplets coming outside of the glass. This is due to condensation. As air contains humidity, that is water vapor, and due to the low temperature near the glass, the water vapor convert into tiny drop and it gets stuck on the glass. This happens due to condensation.